and a very warm welcome to our service of Holy Communion, once again in an empty church other than my colleague Gary and churchwarden Ian on the sound desk. The sound sounds all right to me, it's echoing through the building, but what's more important is how the volume is for you at home. Apologies for last week, for me leaving my microphone on. I thought that would be good for the congregational responses. I didn't realise it was picking up every breath and rustle of paper, so I am sorry that that distracted your worship. And we've put new batteries in this microphone, and they sound as if they're working well. So please do message if there is a problem with the sound, but I think we've done all that we can at this end. Some people's equipment is better than others at volume. It's one of those unfortunate facts. However, here we are to worship God, and today is the festival or feast of Christ the King. And we remember that Christ is King over all, the whole world, and our villages, and our homes, and our hearts, and our lives. So let's have our opening response. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. And our first hymn is, Let All the World in Every Corner Sing.
Say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Come to a time of confession, a time to think about the week that has just been. We think about the things that we've said, the conversations we've had, and whether they're acceptable to our Lord. Just have a brief moment of contemplation. We say together,
Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been.
Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be.
that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Today's collect. God the Father, help us to hear the call of Christ the King and to follow in his service, whose kingdom has no end, for he reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, one glory. Amen.
Amen.
We have our first reading. So the next is a song, Jesus' Name Above All Names.
Oh,
So as we come to listen to the gospel being read by Yvonne, I just thought I would introduce Yvonne. So Yvonne is a reader in training from this benefice. She's normally at All Saints in Denston, but because we're doing this in this particular way today, she is joining us via her video sermon that she would have normally preached actually in church, but obviously due to lockdown. So some of you may have seen her before, some of you may not have, but she's Yvonne and she's a reader in training.
Reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 25, verses 31 to 46, the judgment of the nations. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people, one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep in his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, "Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? Sick or in prison and visited you?" And the king will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me." Then he will say to those at his left hand, "You that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me clothing. Sick, and in prison, and you did not visit me." Then they also answered, "Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry, or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not take care of you?" Then he will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did not do it for one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord
Jesus Christ. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, Lord God, our strength and redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
In this passage, we're given a glimpse of the future glory of Jesus as King and Judge. What a magnificent picture it presents. Jesus sitting on his glorious throne, accompanied by angels, with the nations gathered in attendance before him. This is more than just another parable. This is a real vision describing a real future event. We see a huge contrast here between the first coming and the second coming of Jesus Christ. First, Jesus is a servant born in a stable, and here at the second coming as King in all of his glory, in judgment of the living and the dead. This passage links directly to our creeds, our statements of faith and belief. At this final judgment, we are told the obedient followers will be separated from the pretenders and believers. Sheep and goats are used perfection only. But what we do know is the evidence of our belief, our faith in Christ the King or Christ the Servant, is reflected in the way that we act. To treat all persons we meet as if they were Christ is no easy task. I can't confess that I always do. Do you? But how we treat others demonstrates how we really think about Jesus' words given to us here. Jesus provides us with a humanitarian approach here. Look after the sick, give drink to the thirsty, clothe the naked. I was recently given a new way of looking at sin. If you consider the word sin, with the letter S standing for self-centeredness, being selfish, thinking of oneself first and foremost, and the letter N at the word's end, standing for no God, where there's no God in our thoughts, no God in our actions, and the middle letter I, meaning us personally in the middle. Sin is us standing in the middle of self-centeredness and no God supporting what we do. Can we see the contrast here between what is sin and the actions we are called to do? Actions of giving, caring, generosity, thoughtfulness, and of course the love of God being central to all these actions, being sinless. So, am I safe? Is it really a book in heaven that's got all the good things and the bad things in it that we do, like being naughty or nice at Christmas? I've spent all my working life since I was 17 as a nurse, working in various capacities, tending to the sick, etc. So can I tick off a few boxes here? Or are we being asked to examine our lives, our hearts, our souls, deeply, opening up all of the ugly for God to see? How do our actions separate us from the pretenders and the unbelievers? This parable describes acts of mercy we can all do every day. They don't depend on our wealth, our ability, or our intelligence. Just simple acts, freely given and freely received. There's no excuse to neglect those who have obvious need. What we seek is not always the responsibility of the church or the government. Jesus is demanding our own personal involvement in caring for each other. The one thing to remember is that the other in need spoken about may not be the obvious beggar lying in the cardboard box covered with a duvet with our dog for companionship, or the person selling the big issue. Recently in our Bible study, held via Zoom on Thursday evening with Liz, our minister, she talked about persecution of Christians around the world. Millions of Christians who are suffering persecution today in China, Egypt, India, and a host of Muslim nations. We personally have a responsibility to mobilise opinion, to stop the persecution of Christ's brothers and sisters. Jesus is telling us here in verse 14, "Truly, I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these, who are members of my family, you did it to me." But we know we're more easily moved to action by homeless people on our city streets than by Christian brothers and sisters in received all. But again, are you the least of these that Jesus spoke of as one? Do you feel unloved, unwanted, marginalised and let down by those who should love and cherish you? Are you in a place, or can you ask for help that you need? Can you reach out to those who surround you, friends, family, and us, your brothers and sisters in Christ, asking God for deliverance? Because we are here as church, we're here as your home, waiting for your call. Being a sheep or a goat, it is easy for Matthew to decipher. Generous and caring or walking on the line. But when it comes down to our lives, the nitty and the gritty, it is so much harder for us to separate ourselves. But there is so much hope for us all, making ourselves fit for judgment. Spoken of here isn't easy. But when I look around our benefits, I've seen such incredible acts of generosity, caring, unconditional love. It's absolutely beautiful, especially during our lockdowns. And it's not just for those in Christian faith, but it's been for whole communities. We're not idly doing God's work in this benefice. Jesus tells us that people at the king's right hand inherit the kingdom, salvation, because of small mercies shown to the least of these. What I love about this parable is that both those judged to be honourable and those judged to be dishonourable have exactly the same response. Lord, when was it we saw you hungry? This shows that this effort doesn't come from trying hard. Instead, Matthew points out repeatedly that good fruit comes from good trees. We aren't aware that we're doing good because it comes so naturally. We are human beings, frail and vulnerable. And we don't fit neatly into these preordained groups. What we can ask ourselves as both good and righteous is for God's grace to continue recognizing the opportunities for God's works, for good works. Thank you.
Thank you, Yvonne. Lots of things there to think about.
Excellent.
Yeah. And very strange to sit and listen to that in a room with only three of us here.
Yes.
And I hope the people at home enjoyed that. It's very good. So normally we'd ask you to stand. So if you're able to at home or wherever you are, if you'd stand as we affirm our faith in the words of the Creed. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And we now come to a time of intercession, which is going to be led by the youth group. It's via Zoom, so it's video, and then we'll add some other things onto the end of the intercessions after.
Dear Lord, as we gather online in your name, we pray that you would fill our hearts, minds, and souls. Transform us, Lord, and make us more like you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, victims of tragedy and disaster. We pray for those who die burdened by regrets or resentment. Give strength to those for whom death is a slow agony. Give peace to those who die suddenly and without warning. Comfort those who must watch others die and cannot help them. Lord Jesus Christ, you have been through everything. Stay with me through everything. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear God, we pray today in hope that you will guide our Prime Minister Boris Johnson and all working alongside him in creating this vaccine. We also pray for the lonely this Christmas. We ask you that many, if not all, find comfort within you. We pray that our families will be able to meet this Christmas and after a tough year. We pray that you will bring us out even tougher and ready for the next year.
Heavenly Father, we praise you because you have created a world that is beautiful and awe-inspiring. When we think about the size of the universe, or when we hear the sound of crashing thunder, or feel the power of waves breaking on the seashore, we remember what a great God you are. And then we see the little things like the pattern on a butterfly's wing, the colours of the feathers on a duck, the different shapes of leaves on trees, and we realise that as well as being a very powerful and mighty God, you also care about the little details and have a great sense of beauty. Please teach us to appreciate all that you have made and to enjoy this world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Dear God, we pray for Christians around the world, especially at this difficult and uncertain time.
We ask that you are with all those who are lonely, isolating and in need. Lord, be in a light in the darkness.
Let all people know that you are the ultimate hope, no matter how challenging life is.
We thank you that you are our God of love.
You care for us all and know us completely. Thank you for being with us at every moment, wherever we are. Dear Lord, we pray today for the churches in our benefits, for St Michael's, All Saints, St Giles and St John's. We especially lift up to you all those people who work and support the churches. We thank you for all the people who attend, both in person and at the present time in other ways. We lift them to you, Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Now we all join together to say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. By whom is the kingdom, the power, and the glory,
forever and ever.
Amen.
And Lord, we would also like just to offer up some other people that we feel need your loving touch this morning. So Winnie Pearson, Pat Oakes, Ian Pearson, Sheila Jackson, John McGurr, Pat Austin, Ken Langton, Ina Randall, and any other sick people that we know that need your loving, healing touch this morning, we offer them to you now. also think of the people that have gone before us. Jim Tompkinson, Peter Tipper, Jean Morton, Eileen Warren, June Carpenter, William Tipper, and Roy Plant. And we pray for all of the families of those who mourn the death of their loved ones, no matter how recent or how long ago. We ask, Lord, that you're with them in their preparations for funerals, and you're with them when they realise that they are no longer able to speak to those loved ones. And finally, Lord, we pray for all people who are sick and poorly through COVID. Lord, there are so many names, and we know the names of the ones closest to us. So we just leave a few moments of silence to pray for the people who are sick with COVID, people who are recovering, perhaps the people that have got it but don't know yet. Just a few moments of quiet. Lord, in your mercy. And I thank the youth group for doing that, and the perils of saying things together via Zoom is always a challenge. So thank you for that. Now the peace.
Thank you.
Well, normally saying, would you please stand? To crown all things, there must be love. To bind all together and complete the whole, let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you all. Do a heart or a thumbs up or a something on Facebook.
Yeah.
Peace be with you. And I believe, well, I know we've got a hymn, a song. Can't remember what it is though, so we'll find out. King of Kings, Majesty.
Thank you.
is here. His spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ you shared our life, that we might live in him and he in us. He opened his arms of love upon the cross and made for all the perfect sacrifice for sin. On the night he was betrayed, at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all. As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. So draw near with faith. Oh, you're a bit quick. Draw near with faith. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you, preserve your body and soul to everlasting life. Take and eat this, and those of you at home, make your spiritual communion in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Stir up, we beseech thee, O Lord, the wills of thy faithful people, that they, plenteously bringing forth the fruit of good works, may of thee be plenteously rewarded. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. So we come now to the notices, the blessings, and so on and so forth. We've got birthdays, haven't we? Yes, we've got the anniversaries. Would you like to move the microphone? Thank you. We're doing all we can to be COVID safe here. So the food bank, please continue to drop things off at the vicarage, and thank you very much for your generosity. The stuff keeps coming in, which is brilliant. If you'd like to donate towards the work of the church, please go to our website and you can nominate which of the churches in the benefice you would like that money to go to. We think we've had a gift through to St Michael's, but Litchfield didn't tell us who was the donor. So if you don't get an acknowledgement, it's because we don't necessarily know who it is that's given through that method. But please be assured that if you do give online, we are very grateful for all that you can give us. Birthdays. I haven't checked my phone during the worship. Well, I did at the beginning. But I'm aware of two birthdays today. Margaret Jukes' birthday today. And Anthony Coates' is on Thursday. I haven't noticed anyone else saying a birthday. So happy birthday to Margaret and to Anthony. May God bless you with many more and a wonderful celebration. Albeit not what you would hope for. So God bless you on this day and always. I'm not aware of any wedding anniversaries, and again, nobody's contacted me. So it's Advent soon, Christmas is coming, and we've got plans. Next week is Advent Sunday, and Bishop Michael is not here in person, but is going to be here on the screen. Apparently he was due to preach somewhere and obviously can't, so they're making available his sermon for Advent Sunday. And so we thought, why not? It was only me down to preach, so there you go. Night prayers during Advent will continue at 6 o'clock, and we'll be lighting an Advent ring to do that. And there will be one for you to join in with. There we go. I'm going to amend it slightly because people have pointed out if you put tea lights on paper, it gets a bit hot. So I'm going to redesign it so that we can cut out and it goes on a plate, and so the tea light goes on the plate. That's one of my projects for this week, to do that. And we're going to journey through Advent with angels. Angels will soon start appearing in Roaster and Denston, in the windows. So do a picture of an angel, stick it in your window. Regardless of where you live, let's flood the nation with angels. Knitted angels will appear in Roaster with little messages from the church, so look out for them. Not today, but in Advent, which starts next Sunday. But actually, I'm not sure if the angels are just going to wait till December. Well, I'll stand by and be told by the chief angel, Susan, who's in charge. But I've come across this. It's not quite an Advent calendar, but it's my journey through Advent, printed out on two pieces of A4 and stick them together. And you can do a little picture, a little word, or anything in each of those. But it starts on the 29th of November, not the 1st of December. It actually follows Advent and goes right the way through to Christmas Eve. I'm going to do it. Why don't you join me? You can do whatever you want in each of those circles. Because do you know what? Yvonne mentioned mental health in her sermon, which incidentally I thought was an excellent sermon. Thank you, Yvonne. I will be giving you feedback. But one of the things I've been doing through this lockdown to help people with stress and mental health, and we've all got mental health, some of us have got good mental health, some of us have got a little bit poorly mental health. But one thing that you can do is a bit of doodling, a bit of art, crayons, whatever. And I've been doing a video each day. So please do look out for that. It started off as an elf character, but I've ditched the elf and it's now just me. And ELF, E-L-F, stands for Everyday Loving Fun. So please watch out for that on Facebook, perhaps and you on my YouTube channel. So that's Advent. And we are going to hopefully have, well, I know we will, we'll have mince pies and mulled wine. Dot would like the usual gifts of mince pies and red wine so she can make mulled wine. You can drop them off at Dot's house, you can drop them off at the vicarage. I promise I won't eat them. But if they're not, but if they're for the food bank, please indicate that they are. But if they're mince pies and wine appearing at the vicarage, I'll assume that they're for Dot to do for our hospitality. Croxton, I'm assuming Stephanie Shevlin and others, they'll sort themselves out. They're brilliant at that sort of thing. So please do, if you normally give those items, do so, so we can be hospitable. So what have we got coming up? Saturday, 5th of December, from 10 to 1, there's going to be a stall for St. Michael's Church in Roaster Village Centre, selling all sorts of stuff, or by donation, not quite sure which, and including, I've got some Christmas cards with paintings of Roaster that were given to us to be able to sell for church funds, so they will be there. The next day, Sunday the 6th of December, here at St. Michael's, we'll be having our annual memorial service, or a Blue Christmas, to remember all the loved ones who are no longer with us. We haven't got the capacity for you to come into church and write names on, as normally happens. I think we've probably got the list of names from last year still lurking on someone's computer. We will use that. So if you know a name was remembered last year, be assured it will be remembered this year. Plus, I will add all the names of the funerals that have come through me and this benefice on that list. If you know, if you want to add anyone else to it, please let me know. If we're allowed to worship in church, it will happen in church. And it will go out on Facebook Live, plus saved up on YouTube, and so on. The next Sunday, 13th of December, there'll be a Chris Dingle at 10:30 here. Again, it'll go out on Facebook. And a 3 o'clock carol service and the raffle prizes given out at St Giles's in the car park. That's the 13th. It's not working. Oh, there we go. The 20th, we've got carols and nativity in St John's Churchyard at 10:30. And a lockdown nativity our youth play during the service here, which is possibly as we speak being recorded. The youth are doing it by Zoom and recording it and putting it together. Looking forward to that. And at 6 o'clock that night, we'll be having a pre-recorded traditional carol service for the benefice. And that's your traditional 9 lessons and carols. If you would like to be involved in that and read a reading, you saw Joshua do it, you saw the youth group do it, you saw Yvonne do it. It's easy enough. Someone can hold a phone in front of you. We'll get it recorded. If you'd like to take part and do one of those readings, please let me or Gary know, because we'll be putting it together. Whether we can actually sing outside or not is another matter. We wait to be told. The 22nd, on a Tuesday, this is new, 7 o'clock, at the Roaster Football Car Park, we are going to have a drive-in carol service. Never done one before. I think it's not going to be a traditional 9 lessons and carols. It's going to be something else. But there will be carols. There'll be mulled wine and mince pies. It'll be the Christmas story in one way or another. Please, I don't know what the capacity of the car park is. I don't know how many people want to come. We may sort of do it ticketed in some way, get you to say that you're coming. That's still in the planning stage. And Christmas Eve is almost normal. We'll have Croxton and Hollington joint Chris Dingle in the car park at Croxton. at 3 o'clock. I want to do a Zoom or a Facebook type nativity, something online, in a live chat room or a Zoom or something. We're making it up as we don't know, do we, Gary? So let me and Gary know if you're interested, and we'll gauge interest and then decide what to do. 9:30, the Bethlehem Communion at All Saints. 11:30, Midnight Communion here at St Michael's. And Christmas Day, 10 o'clock Communion here at St Michael's. And all the services from St Michael's will continue to be out on Facebook. So I think that's it. Any other notices? No. The final hymn seems to be placed after the dismissal. We normally... Well, let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord, and hopefully we've got a final hymn. I think I put one in. Yes. My mistake.
To love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ.